Since Google started giving away free credits, hosting website on Google Cloud Platform is really interesting, especially if you are a small to medium traffic website. In this video, we'll show you how to set up a WordPress on GCP in just a few minutes. Let's check it out. Here's the Google Cloud Platform console. If this is the first time for you, you will be asked to create your first project. But since I already host my website on this platform, I'm going to create a new project for this tutorial. Now we need to wait for a few seconds before we can switch to the new project. Let's head to the Compute Engine section and select VM Instance. Here you can create your own virtual machine as your server. It's almost the same as purchasing a VPS package from web hosting, but this time you will have full control and ability to scale or upgrade it later. The downside is, you will have to manage it by yourself, which requires some technical background, and there is no convenient tools like cPanel or plesk. From here, there are two options to set up your instance. You can create your virtual machine here and install all the packages by yourself, or you can use the deployment solution provided on the marketplace. For this tutorial, we will go with the easy way and use the existing solution. Let's head to the Deployment Manager and select Deployment. Then click Go to Marketplace. From here, you can choose the existing solution to deploy on your project. For example, if you want to host a website using Apache, you can deploy a LAMPStack solution, which will create an instance for you and auto-install all the required packages. Now, since Google has a free tier that lets you use the smallest VM instance like F1 Micro for free, this tutorial is going to focus on staying under that condition. And since the CPU and RAM is limited for F1 Micro, I recommend you to use a lightweight web server like OpenLightSpeed instead of Apache. Let's select OpenLightSpeed from Marketplace and click Launch on Compute Engine. Here you can rename the deployment if you want. Zone is where your VM instance will be placed. You can change zone to match the website audience, but remember that free tier allows only US zone. Next is the VM instance. Here you can select machine type with suitable CPU and RAM, but for small to medium static website, the F1 Micro should be enough for most cases. Next is the disk size, which is default to 10 gigs, but since free tier allows up to 30, so why not? Then make sure you allow all web traffic on firewall setting. Then click deploy and wait for a few minutes. Now the deployment has finished. Next, we will reserve the static IP address for our server. Go to our VM instance and select View Network Detail. Then select External IP Address. You will see that our current IP type is ephemeral, which means it will change over time, so let's change it to static. If you go to this IP address on browser now, it will tell you to set up the server with Secure Shell first, so let's do it. You can connect by click the SSH button on your instance. Then you will be asked to enter your domain name. I'm going to skip the SSL setting for now. Finally, update the server to the latest version. This will take 5 to 10 minutes. So in the meantime, let's set up the WordPress by go to your IP address. Select the language and create a WordPress admin user. And that's it. Your WordPress is ready. You can log in and start customizing your website now. Then update the DNS setting to point to this VM instance IP address and your website is ready. With the current setting, it should be able to take on around 1000 users a day easily, and even more if you use Cloudflare or Cache plugin. But since our server RAM is quite limited, it's best to also turn on a swap file. This is to allocate some disk spaces to be used as memory when RAM is running low. First, we'll allocate the file with 1GB size. Then set the file permission. Then select our file to be used as a swap. And then turn it on. Our swap setup is complete, but this is only temporary. If you restart the server, it will be gone, so we need to write the setting permanently. Now to keep track of CPU and RAM usage, you can view it in Stack Driver. For some resources like CPU, you can view it right away, but for RAM, you will need to install an agent first. You can use Google provided command to pull the install script and execute it. The install is complete, but if you check the status, it will fail. This is because we need to enable the meta setting of our instance first. Head back to the VM instance and click Edit. Then change the monitoring metadata from 0 to 1. Then restart the service and check the status again. Now it's running. You should see a check mark in the stack driver. To view RAM usage, select Resources and Metrics Explorer. First, enter GCE VM instance as resource type. Then select memory usage. Now you can see usage statistic report at any time. And that should cover the basic steps. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe for more dev tips and tutorials. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye!